Hello children, here I am with my new video, and in this video I am going to solve sums of exercise 5.3. So let's start. See what is written in my question. Solve the following systems of simultaneous linear equations by cross multiplication method. You have to be careful, the name of method is written, so we have to follow this method only, okay? So first of all, we have copied the question. 3x plus 2y is equals to 4, and then 8x plus 5y is equals to 9. The question was 3x plus 2y is equals to 4, 8x plus 5y is equals to 9. As I have explained you during my concept video, where I have given you the concept of all the methods, I told you for cross multiplication you have to keep one thing in your mind, that this constant term must be on left hand side. With these terms, with the terms of x and y, we have to bring that constant number, whatever is on right side, you have to bring that number in left hand side, so that you can arrange in this form. Their equation must be in this form so that you can follow the rules of cross multiplication method. So what I did, I have transferred this 4 here and 9 here, so equation is like this. 3x plus 2y minus 4 equals to 0, 8x plus 5y minus 9 is equals to 0, and numbered is at 1 and 1. There is no requirement to write 1 and 2 because they are not going to use equation number. So we just written here, and then start write the coefficient of the pair of these linear equations as a1 is equals to 3, b1 is equals to 2, c1 is equals to minus 4, a2 is 8, b2 is 5, c2 is minus 9. Okay, by cross multiplication method the solution is given by, as I taught you, that first of all I have to write the value of for x. So I have written x in numerator, and in denominator we will write these two, coefficient of y and coefficient of 1. So what is the coefficient of y? This will be in our equation, this is bc, because we are writing about x. So bc minus bc, I told you. So first of all, I have written on my own also, I have written bc minus bc, and then I have written 1 2 and 2 1. Fine children. And for y, what we will do, this was b1 y, b2 y. For y, what we will do from here, we'll start. So it is ca minus ca, is it? Okay, so I have written ca minus ca, and then 1 2 2 1. And for this constant number, coefficient of 1, so here was x, here is y, here is 1. So I have written 1, and then ab minus ab. Then I have written ab minus ab, and then numbered it 1, 2, 2, 1. And just you put the values. This is the main work of this question, this type of question. So first of all, you written it correctly, and then put the values and solve it. You will reach to your answer. So x upon b1 c2. In place of b1, I have written 2. In place of c2, I have written minus 9. Okay, minus b2 c1. So where is b2? Here is 5. And what is c1? Here is c1. So minus 4. Okay, y upon c1 a2. What is c1? C1 is minus 4. a2 is 8. c2 a1. What is c2? Minus 9 and 3. You be careful and see what I have done. Minus sign we can't ignore. We have used a bracket because there are two signs. So I have used small bracket, and at last 1 upon a1 b2. So what is a1? 3, and b2 is 5. So 3 into 5 minus b1 a2. So 2 into 8. A2 into 2, because a2 is 8. So now we will start solving the sum. Normal calculation, 9 into 2 is minus 18. Always remember one thing. Mostly I found the students are doing mistake here, because they are very careless during multiplication, during putting the sign of minus or plus. Be careful. If you are a math student, you have to be so focused, at least till the maths will end. Till then, don't try to divert your mind here and there. Because mostly I have deducted marks in examination in these lines, where children are doing mistakes, silly mistakes in calculation. So take all the things seriously, children, okay? Minus 18, 5, 4, 20, plus 20. Y upon 8 4s are 32, minus 32, minus minus plus 9 3s are 27 is equals to 1 upon 5 3s are 15, minus 16, 8 2s are 16. Right now, x upon minus 18 plus 20 is what? एक्स अपॉन टू, माइनस 18 प्लस 20 इज 2, हियर इज माइनस 32 प्लस 27, सो इट इज माइनस 7, माइनस 5 सॉरी, एंड 15 माइनस 16 इज माइनस 1. सो ओवरऑल वी आर हैविंग x by 2 is equals to y by minus 5 is equals to 1 by minus 1. So once we will equate first term with last and then second term with last. So I did the same. I have written x by 2 is equals to minus 1. 1 by minus 1 means minus 1, right? So x is equals to what? 2 into minus 1 into 2, that is minus 2. This is your first answer, value of x. And second, I have equated these two. Y by minus 5 is equals to minus 1. 1 by minus 1 is minus 1. So y is equals to minus 1 into minus 5, that is 5. So these are the values of x and y. And here your answer is over. Now we will see question number 2, sub question 1. Solve the following pairs of linear equation by cross multiplication method. First question is x minus y is equals to a plus b. Ax plus by is equals to a square minus b square. You must remember what your teacher told you for cross multiplication. You will shift this number because already x and y is in LHS, and whatever constant number is written here in RHS, you shift all number in LHS. So I did the same thing. See what I have done. Children, be careful what I am going to explain you. Listen, x minus y, instead of writing minus a minus b, I have taken whole number together and then written minus a plus b. You know why? Because I want to set it as three terms. Okay, I want to set like this. I am having x term, y term, and last one as one constant term. So instead of writing separately, I have written together so that it looks like a single term. And similarly, ax plus by, and then I transferred whole number together, because you will feel confused what's going on, because you now if you will take it separately, then you will see there are four different terms. So in a bracket I transferred together and it is minus a square minus b square. Okay, now again we will follow the same rule. A1 is equals to what is the coefficient of x? Nothing, means 1. Coefficient of b1, it is minus 1. C1 is minus a plus b. A2 is a, b2 is b, and c2 is minus a square minus b square. Okay, now we are using the same formula. So I have written the formula. I'm not going to explain anymore. So I'm just putting the values. Instead of writing b1 c2, I have written minus 1, and for c2 I have written minus a square minus b square. Okay, see carefully, you use it. I've used a curly bracket, then minus sign, then a square minus b square, then both the bracket close, small bracket as well as curly bracket. Minus b2 c1, what is b2? b2 is b, so I've written b. And what is c1? c1 is minus a plus b, so I have to write minus a plus b, but we have to show the bracket sign also. So I've used curly bracket, minus a plus b, both the bracket close, done. Now for y, what I have done? Y is c1 a2, what is c1? Minus a plus b, so I have written minus a plus b into a2. So what is a2? a2 is a, written here a, then minus c2 a1, in place of c2 I have written curly bracket minus a square minus b square, because I have to show this minus sign also, and that formula of minus sign, so both are here, but there is a wall of bracket. So now c2 into a1 was 1, so I have written here 1. Then equals to 1 upon, there was no space, so I have used second page also. So 1 upon a1 b2, what is a1? a1 is 1 and b2 is b, so it is 1 into b minus a2 b1. a2 is a and b1 is minus 1, so I have used bracket sign to show minus 1. Now start solving the sum. Careful, you have to be focused during this type of calculation, because minor mistake will spoil your answer. So first of all, I have opened this minus, this bracket, to utilize this minus sign. Okay, so this minus sign is here, and this minus will change all the signs. So this is minus a square and this is plus b square. Okay, minus b, and this minus sign will change these signs. So minus a into minus b, and here also this minus sign will change the sign of these number, so minus a into minus b into a minus, again this minus change the sign, So minus a square and minus minus plus b square into 1, and here b into 1 is b, and a minus 1 is minus minus plus a. Okay. Now what? Again we are opening the bracket. So this minus will change the sign. Here is a square minus b square. Okay. And this minus b into minus a is what? Plus a b. Minus minus plus. Again minus minus plus, and b into b square. Now we can see here is minus b square plus b square. So what is the remaining thing? X upon a square upon a plus b. And this side, minus a into a is minus a square. Minus b into a is minus a b. Minus. Now see children, this one is multiplied, so I just copied here. Okay, and I haven't opened the bracket. This one is multiplied, there will be no change because we are multiplying with one. So this is minus a square plus b square, and here is 1 by a plus b. I just rearranged the numbers. X upon, here is x, a square plus a b, already I have explained you here. And y upon what? A minus a square minus a b. Now we are opening the bracket. This minus minus plus a square, and this minus and plus is, this minus and plus will be minus b square, right? So is equals to 1 upon a plus b. Now what? X upon a square plus a b is equals to, now minus a square plus a square cancel. So y upon minus a b minus b square equals to 1 by a plus b. Now we will equate these two to get the answer of a, and then middle one and last one to get the answer of y. So I did the same. X upon a square plus a b is equals to 1 upon a plus b. X is your a square plus a b upon a cross multiplication. We will take a as common. So what is the remaining thing? A plus b. So a plus b cancelled. X is equals to a is your answer. And similarly, y upon minus a b minus b square is equals to 1 by a plus b. So y is equals to, by cross multiplication, here is minus a b minus b square. We will take the minus b. You can take this minus b or here also, no need to carry it till then. You can take a as common from this place only, that is okay, no problem. Minus b is common, so inside the bracket a plus b, a plus b, a plus b cancel. So b is, y is equals to minus b. So these are the two